Morning, everybody. I just wanted to answer some comments on other people's videos. Because I read comments and I discover out there who are snakes, who are lowlifes. But, there's lots of misinformation out there about Philippines, immigration, home ownership, gun ownership. There's a lot of misinformation out there. All right. True. I am not a Philippine citizen, so I cannot own a gun over there. But my wife can, because she's U.S. and Philippine. Why do you think I trained her on the 1911 and the Mossberg 500 and 590? Because they sell those over there. Yeah, private gun ownership is there. They can own all they want, as long as they can afford it, and it's got to go through the government and be reviewed. And then presto. You go down to the gun store and buy a gun. Yeah. Another thing about home ownership is chances are if you're conversing with someone over in the Philippines and they tell you that you cannot own a home over there, it's probably because they're ignorant or they don't want you to move in over there. You get it? Okay. I am half owner of our house over there. Half owner. The other half owner is my wife, and the house and all of the properties are willed. If she passes away, then they come to me. And if I pass away, then all of the property goes to her. You have to go through the courts. You have to hire an attorney and have all the paperwork started and get the paperwork finished. And I've already signed all that stuff. Did that back in, I'm not sure what year it was. But I stayed at the family's house for about a week while my wife was doing all the legal paperwork, because it takes a long time and it's wearing on a foreigner's patience, because the court system there, same with the getting a loan and getting property, takes a long time. So she just left me at the family's home. Well, she went and took care of all that. Well, the property is in my wife's name and my name. And my brother is the power of attorney and his wife. They are the power of attorney over our home and our property. So there's a lot of misconceptions, because sometimes it's because of ignorance and sometimes because, well, they just don't want you to move over there. There's another little known fact about immigration. If you want to bring somebody into the U.S., you're financially responsible for that person. If you don't meet the full requirements of financial responsibility, you can get a co-signer. Right? My wife's cousin, her now husband for years, he didn't make enough money to be able to meet the government requirements. You can get a co-signer for that. So those are just some rumors that spread around YouTube and by all the YouTube experts who have never been to the Philippines and have never traveled. And generally speaking, the people who have never traveled, well, there's a reason for it. It's because they've spent most of their life with a whiskey bottle or a glass pipe with meth in it, wasting their time and wasting their life away. You can afford to travel. Just get a passport and go. Take a chance in life. Why not? Oh, and as far as living dangerously, the stuff does kick off in Mindanao. It does. It does. But the reason why I like living there, I want to grow old and die there, is because their legal system has teeth in it over there, guys. Believe me, it does. If you commit a crime against a senior citizen over there, oh, you're not going to like the end result when the police show up. Oh, you're not going to like that. And let me tell you this, I do know this for a fact, that if you don't have any money, and you don't have someone to take care of your finances while you're in jail, you're going to spend 5 to 8 years before you even get a bond hearing. 5 to 8 years. And who knows, the court might deny you bond. Yeah. That's why I like living there when you get older, because the drug problem, they know how to handle it. The courts have teeth in it. The courts does not have a revolving door in the prison system over there. If you do something heinous, you're going to go away for a long time. So, just answering some questions, responding to some comments. So, thanks for watching. Later, all.